Is it desert?
I've never been here before. I've been here before, but never during the winter, because I was told, like, you can't come here. You're desert people. It gets cold here. And so I was nervous. I prepped. I watched nature shows. Did all the hard research. I found Human Planet, directed by David Attenborough from the BBC. I don't know if you've heard of it. It's really good. So I looked up the Freezing Wastelands episode. And it starts off with only one man has conquered all the corners of the planet. And there's this long dramatic pause, like, it's like a lobster. It's us, human beings. Obviously. Okay. How do I survive in Montreal? Just get to the point. I'm seeing this. It was like in Switzerland, they're throwing dynamite to cause early avalanches so that like a big one doesn't form. And then, you know, like in somewhere in Canada, I forget where the weather goes, maybe Toronto, they have to plow the streets like three times a week with these vehicles that are supposed to cause deaths every year. And then I find out, oh my god, it's like a winter wasteland. And then I call ahead of time, and I find out, yeah, this is what happened in Montreal. We have this snow brigade that comes in, and it's gonna wipe the streets clean, and there's gonna be like three people a year are killed by these things. It's unavoidable. Three people. As I looked into it, it's like you guys get 2.1 meters of snow every year. In 2008, you had 8 meters in this one snowstorm. There's 59 snow days. Oh my god. I had to go buy boots, I had to get gloves and a jacket. Do you know how hard it is to find that? It's really easy. It's very large. When I get here, what the hell? What is this? What's going on? It's raining, first off. I'm not an expert. I might need to get Morgan out here with the lab coat, but you can't have rain if it's below freezing. And walking down the street and there's just people just in t-shirts like, bonjour. Bonjour? Bonjour? I was promised blood in the streets. Frozen. By the snow blitzkrieg that comes in. One truck, followed by another truck, followed by a little golf cart. Frozen blood. So, yeah, I was wearing a Hawaiian shirt. There's no sleep here. The other thing I was a little annoyed by was that everyone knows about Trump here. And that's really embarrassing. I mean, I already tell people I'm English-Canadian. I was kind of hoping maybe after Obama's run, I could be like, American. But now it's just out of the question. And to be honest, I'm actually thinking I might vote for him. Like, don't be mad, I just think it could be kind of cool to basically elect Biff Tannen. That's the retreat back then. And I could just, you know, kind of help cause the like alternate timeline. Marty! TV show persona got elected president. What did you do? I just think it could be, I don't know, it's going out of control now over there. It's basically TV. Everything's a TV show. I don't know, you guys do an election, it lasts like a week. We started like a year ago. Basically, when the last election ended, the next one started. Well, everyone found out Obama's going to be president for the full 2 terms, and we're like, all right, well, it's going to be the next guy. So now, I think, you know, Trump, I think it just might be kind of fun. I think I might, you know, help elect him, throw in a vote for Arizona, and then, you know, get to a safe distance. Maybe move to Montreal, pack a bathing suit. And then just kind of watch the whole country sort of implode on itself in a marble, gold crater. Just sort of elect all the TV show personas. Why not go, just go crazy with them? This is the cave boss. He's going to be our public health secretary. This is the cast of Survivor. They're going to be housing and development. Here's Exhibit. He's going to handle the public transportation. We turned all your trains into maglev trains. And I'm like, oh my God. Sitting on my lawn, watching that happen safely in a balmy Montreal. Thank you.
Steven Ruggeri!